This video is brought to you by Gradient. Some days ago, IBM released a new AI chip called Northpole. It's 20 times faster and 25 times more energy efficient than any other AI chip on the market. And what's interesting, it even outperforms NVIDIA H100 GPU, which is fabricated in more advanced process node. As a chip designer, I'm impressed by this masterpiece of engineering. Let me explain. What makes this chip so interesting is that it implements neuromorphic architecture. It drives the inspiration from the way our brain works. And our brain is vastly more energy efficient than any silicon chip on Earth. You can have a chip with hundreds of megabytes of SRAM, so you can fit your entire application on there. But you still have to read the SRAM and get this data to the processing unit. And this process of moving and shuffling the data around takes a lot of time and energy. And we can address this bottleneck the way our brain does, because my brain has no off-chip memory, at least for now. So we can apply the same approach to computing by performing computing operations directly in the memory.
So one of the most fundamental properties of neuromorphic architecture is that there's no external memory. The memory, which in a conventional processor is the DRAM, you know, or your cache, right, that's sitting apart from the processor, in some cases far on a different chip, right, in the case of DRAM. That's not the case in a neuromorphic architecture. The memory elements are intertwined at a very fine scale. They're close to the processing elements where the neural processing is happening.
And to this end, IBM has built the computing structure around the memory. Now, IBM's Northpole chip is a fully digital chip. It is fabricated using 12 nanometer CMOS technology, which is a mature process node. And that's perfect, because unlike analog, digital is fully scalable. It means that this chip can be fabricated in a 5 or 3 nanometer process in the future, which will allow even better computing efficiency. Here is the Northpole chip. It's designed by IBM Research Lab in California. It's actually the next generation of the True North chip. Do you guys still remember it? Let me know in the comments, because IBM presented the True North chip first time back in 2015. And its new generation, the Northpole chip, is roughly 4,000 times faster than the previous chip. Oh, wow. It's built of 22 billion transistors placed on 800 square millimeters of silicon. So it's a pretty big chip. Here you can see its architecture. The memory is colored in blue and compute is in red. You see, it has many computing engines distributed across the chip, and each has a memory closely intertwined with the computing engine. With that on-chip memory, they are able to store entire networks on the chip during the computation. And in case we run a neural network which is too big, too large to fit on a single Northpole chip, then we can distribute it across several of them. Now, let's have a look what they've achieved with this chip. It's described in this paper, which is beautifully called Neural Inference at the Frontier of Energy, Space and Time. I love it. And here they've listed almost all AI chips which are currently on the market. And they did a pretty solid comparison here. Starting from the top, they listed here Intel chips, Google TPU V4, then Intel Habana chip, Qualcomm chip, the next is Baidu chip, then two Amazon chips, then TSP by Applied Brain Research. Then they've got Sambanova chip, GraphCore IPU. I have no idea what is this one. Then Cerebras VaporScale Engine 2, another Intel chip. And then all the NVIDIA chips, starting with V100, all the way to the A100 GPU and the latest H100 GPU. And they list here the process nodes, power consumption, throughput, and energy. Let's focus on the energy first. It actually shows us the power consumption for each throughput of the chip. And these values and these results are achieved using ResNet 50 benchmark. which is widely used for image classification. When they compare it to NVIDIA V100 GPU, which is also fabricated in the same technology at 12 nanometers, Norse Pole delivers 25 times more frames per joule. In other words, it's 25 times more energy efficient. And on this benchmark, it even outperforms the latest NVIDIA H100 GPU, which is taped out in more advanced process node at 4 nanometers. 4 nanometer transistors are, by default, have greater energy efficiency. Still, despite that, Norse Pole is 5 times more energy efficient. Let me know what you think in the comments. To me, that's impressive. And they've achieved this energy efficiency by implementing in-memory computing and also high data parallelism, again due to its decentralized memory. Now, let's have a look at the time-space metric. Put it simply, it describes how much time it takes for a chip to perform computations, so to say, to arrive to a result. When we compare Norse Pole to NVIDIA V100, it's 18 times faster. And in comparison to the latest NVIDIA H100 GPU, it is 8 times faster, while achieving a latency 22 times lower. And that's cool. What's interesting, out of all the chips listed here, only 3 mentioned which have on-chip memory. This is the Wafer Scale Engine 2 from Cerebras, TSP from Applied Brain Research, and IBM's Norse Pole. There are a bunch of other chips which are, for some reason, didn't make it onto this list. But before we discuss them, if you are looking to incorporate AI into your product to help to drive more value to your business, there is an easy solution. Let's say you want to build a chatbot that manages customer support or helps you with scheduling. A process to build a custom AI application like this can be challenging. However, Gradient makes it easy and cost-effective. Creating a chatbot typically requires a large language model, and fine-tuning a large language model can significantly increase the accuracy and overall performance. The only problem is that this process of fine-tuning the model can be complex and expensive, requiring specialized hardware and resources. And this is where Gradient can help you. Gradient is a platform that provides simple web APIs for fine-tuning the models, generating completions and embeddings. With just a few lines of code, you can fine-tune the state-of-the-art open-source models like Llama 2, Bloom 560, and others to help you create a private AI application. You can use JavaScript, Python, or Gradient command line interface, whatever you like, and you only pay for the tokens that you use. If you sign up to Gradient AI through the link below, you will get $5 in free credits to get started. Now, where the new IBM's Norse Pole chip will be used? IBM is positioning this chip for AI inference application to run already pre-trained AI models on different devices. Locally, like on my phone, and by that avoid the cloud, and drastically reduce the latency and improve the privacy.
Today, if you look at the progress that's being made, very, very exciting what's happening with conventional architectures and conventional very large, you know, transformer networks, right? So I would not bet against this conventional architecture in terms of overcoming the limitations today that it faces. But I think where neuromorphic architecture clearly thrives, and I think that it's very clear that it will succeed in the long term, I believe, is where we need to deploy this intelligence into devices that respond to real world change and stimulus and have to control systems. So in response to that stimulation, make decisions, inferences, adapt to add, you know, to its knowledge, and to do that in this real-time setting. So the way I look at it is if you're wanting to deploy intelligence to the data center, and you're going to have, you know, vast troves of knowledge that are built up in data sets, databases that exist on disk, right, next to those processors. Conventional architectures are probably going to do very well for a long period of time for that. On the other hand, if you want to deploy the intelligence out into the world, in systems, in your vehicles, into robots, or even into just your cell phone, maybe, you know, that there's that real-time interaction that's required, that's where neuromorphic computing will really thrive and succeed in the future.
In the papers, I mentioned that North Pole can be placed in the devices locally and be used for image and speech recognition, as well as for natural language processing. It can be also used in satellites to monitor agriculture or wildlife population. Actually, a great example here that North Pole can be used as a brain in autonomous vehicles and robots. And the reason researchers see the neuromorphic architecture as the most suitable for robotics is because our brain has evolved over a long period of time to control organs and bodies and to learn patterns from the world and adapt to it. That's where IBM's North Pole chip could thrive. IBM is not the only company working on neuromorphic chips. Also, Intel has been developing their Loi 2 chip for several years now. This chip is still in the research phase, and the most interesting thing about it that it's implementing spiking neural networks, which is an entirely different class of neural networks that directly mimics our brain activity. It has no synchronous clock, just like our brain. That's a really interesting project. I have a separate video about them. It will be linked below. Then, what about the Akida chip? It's developed by an interesting startup, BrainChip, originally from Australia, which has created quite a buzz from investors. They were the first company to commercialize the neuromorphic technology, to bring the first neuromorphic chip to the market. And their chip is also fully digital. It's fabricated in 28 nanometers by TSMC. And they also make use of spiking-based model, just like our brain. Then there is a DynAPP chip by SimSense, which is a spin-off from the University of Zurich and ETH Zurich. And they're also developing chips to be used at edge and for robotics. You see, many companies and investors are seeing a lot of potential in neuromorphic computing. And that's why this space is getting pretty crowded and competitive. Because apart of the digital chips we discussed, there are also several projects ongoing which are working on analog neuromorphic chips, which are using different flavors of analog memory. One of them is another IBM chip, Hear Me, which I discussed in my previous video about a month ago. Here, they're using phase change memory to perform in-memory computing, and they have been getting pretty great results with it. But the big difference here that digital memory store binary values, zeros or ones, while analog memory can store several values each. That basically allows the chip to store more information in the same amount of space. Let's say to store 4 or 8 bits in just one memory cell. As a result, it can perform calculations much more energy efficient. It's also worth mentioning NeuroRAM AI chip from Stanford. This is a similar one, but instead of phase change memory, they use analog resistive memory. Finally, there is a famous US-based startup, Mythic, which is working on analog AI chips. There were a lot of discussions about Mythic over the last several years. They ran out of capital by the end of last year, but luckily this spring raised $13 million more and have kept working on their analog AI chip. But they've now pivoted and are focusing more on the defense sector. Still, I would say analog approach is in the research phase and has certain limitations. Usually new memory techniques which are used here, like phase change memory, resistive memory, ECRAM, and so on, they are not yet so mature and robust as multi-bit digital memory. What makes it even more complicated that in order to run your AI models on analog chips, you need to do additional pre-training of the models. And there are still many things that have to be figured out. So what do you think, guys? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. To me, the performance of the North Pole is truly impressive. And especially that it beats even NVIDIA H100 GPU on some of the benchmarks. However, I think it will still take quite some time, maybe 3 to 5 years, until we see this chip or such chips being deployed in the real systems. If IBM ever decides to move forward and create a product out of it. What I can say, with the advent of humanoid robots, we will definitely see more chips, more custom chips like this one, being created for these applications. And computing at edge is really where neuromorphic computing can stand out. If you enjoyed this video, leave me a comment below and share it with your friends. Remember to check out Gradient with the link below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao!